Welcome to tutorial number 18, vector-based art versus pixelated art. In this tutorial, we're going to look at the two and see how they're very different and see how one can be very, very useful, especially when scaling up your images. Right now, I'm working on a cartoon and everything is designed. The characters, the set is designed in Adobe Photoshop. And so using vector-based materials and shape layers, you are able to scale up things like the characters, for instance, so you can zoom in on them and export that as a JPEG or something and snapshot that for a close-up, an extreme close-up, and then zoom it back down, scale it back down, if you will, for an extreme long shot without getting over-pixelated, which really destroys your edge. And I'll actually show you what happens when you scale up when it comes to scaling things up and destroying the edge. We've got this duck here, and it's on a black background to help us see. You notice I chopped off the top of the head. That's a clean line. Everything else sort of has a feather to it. We're going to hit Control D and hold Alt and Shift at the same time. Start scaling up this duck, and we'll move it down over here. Scale it up even some more. And you'll notice even around the high contrast areas, such as the eyes, and you'll notice you double click and sort of feathers it out a little bit. But overall, on a rounded edge, you still get the rough line, and it's really noticeable in some cases. Photoshop does its best to try to erase the edge and smooth things out, but overall, you're still going to notice it quite a bit when you're working with pixelated art. And by pixelated art, I mean anything that you actually paint in with a brush or something like this. Grab my tablet here, and we'll do, a red line here, and we'll make it a real harsh edge. Hardness at 100. We'll do some long lines of that. You can even tell it has some pixelation already, but if we were to scale this up, double click, you sort of get a fuzzy edge. And that fuzzy edge is sometimes not what you're really looking for. So you may want to use the vector-based art. And when you use vector-based art, there are two tools that you'll want to look into. It's either the shape layer tool or the pen tool. With the shape layer tool, you simply go up to here at the top and say, hey, make this a shape layer. Don't make it a path or fill pixels. If you fill pixels, it's non-vector based. It's the same thing that we just did with the brush. Vector based actually fills in the whole layer that it makes here. So this is actually filled in all in red, this whole canvas, but it makes a mask with it. And you can actually move this mask around too. There is a way that you unlink this, select the mask, and you can move it around separately or even adjust it. I believe it would be with your direct selection tool here or something like that. But notice when you do move this object around, you're not updating the red layer underneath. You're actually updating the window or masked out area. So it's masking out all of this behind and it's simply showing the red in the middle. And the great thing about this is if you hit Control T, you can scale this up as big as you want. Check out an edge. And it's still sharp. If we select off that layer, you still got that really crisp line. And the nice thing also is there's so many different things. You've got the rectangle tool, rounded rectangle, edge tool. We've got elliptical tools, polygonal tools, lines, and even custom shapes, sort of like this copyright. We got music symbols, all of these things up here, trademark. All of those things can be very, very useful, and they're very, very customizable as well. The other tool to take note of is the pen tool. We've looked at it in the past. It is a very hard to understand tool at first, but it is so darn useful. It really is. I can't tell you how many times I use this pen tool. But basically, you get to draw out custom shapes and make really, really interesting shapes overall. And of course, it's all very editable in the end. So we were to do something like this. Now, if we hold down the Control key, we can select all these different key points and move them. Like in this case, we have these, they're tied together. Let's say we only want to move one of these sides. Hold down the Alt key, and it actually allows you to move one handle at one time. You can even add more vector layers on top of this. You can add a vector layer on that same one and sort of add to that selection and whatnot, but overall, you would want to create this in many different layers. And once again, this is something that you could easily scale up as large as needed. And you still got that really clean line to it on the edge. And with that said, guys, that is the difference between vector-based art and pixelated art. It becomes real handy when scaling things up. I suggest using vector-based materials whenever possible, just because the clean lines and flexibilities that you get with it. So I'm Dave from Sonic Group Studios. I want to say thanks once again for watching my tutorials, and as always, stay tuned for more.